Correct. Hello, everybody. This is Jessica from Forever Growing. And sitting here to my left is my husband, Tim. Now, my husband, Tim, is the mastermind behind the 3D printing of the Spin-e-Kube. However, he doesn't spin. So I figured one of the best ways to do a beginning spinner video would be to take someone who's never spun and me. Talk them through it. All right, so I'm going to step out of the picture. All right, so what I want to do is explain the parts to you. All right, so when you open this thing up out of the box, you should see the plain box and a whole lot of parts. There will be a little black cord attached to the eye hook. That's your brake. The big gold piece sits, copper piece sticking up in front of you. That is your main bearing support. Underneath of that, if you look closely, there's a little wheel underneath of there, and that is where your motor is. So that's what drives your motor. All right, so the first piece you're going to need is called the flyer. Okay, so the flyer, you want to lay that down on top of your machine. All right. Are all the hooks pointed in the same direction?
No.
All right. Put all the hooks in the same direction. If you have to move one, go ahead and move one. All right. Now, do you see a hole in the top of it?
Yes.
All right. So you need to see the hole in the top of it and all the hooks pointed in the same direction. There you go. Now, set that down for a minute. This is your drive belt. So this is what makes your spinny wheel run. So down in that little hole, I want you to hook it up to the drive belt. All right. And then if you see the little wheel on the back of that flyer, yep, you're going to put the drive belt right there and stick it in the hole. Yep, there you go. And push it all the way back. It shouldn't go through. It should stop. Okay? And if you look down on top of it, you're going to see that the belt is kind of lined up between the two wheels. Okay.
Yes.
The next piece that you're going to need is the back spindle support. It looks just like the front one, only it has this little notch. Now, that little notch is going to slide into the little piece on the base. It doesn't line up naturally with the bearing until you pick it up and you put it in there. Okay? You may get a little bit of resistance trying to push it in, stuff like that. Okay, and I just did it in the wrong order, so I'm going to make you take it apart again. Grab a bobbin. All right, when you first get your spinny cube, you get three bobbins. You only need one to start spinning. Okay, you will also need to provide your own piece of yarn. Pick one that's like 3 foot long. Stick it through the big holes and out the other big hole.
On the non-break or the?
On the non-break side.
Break side, non-break side.
Right. And I've got pictures on the website, on my blog, that have pictures of the different parts and their names for you to reference. So you could probably print those out if you wanted to. All right. So, now that you've got that little back piece off, you're going to slide the bobbin onto the end. There we go. So you want the brake, which is the big groove here, by the brake. Yep, go ahead and slide that in and line it up. There you go. Now, Here's where the fun begins. This next part of what you're going to do is going to really kind of set how easy it is for you to spin. So lay the suede over there and through the eye hook and into the, what do we call that thing?
Break? The wavy break?
Yeah, what's the wavy break?
The wavy break.
The wavy break. It has a name.
Yeah, I called it the wavy break when I designed it.
Okay. Now, you also have to plug in the machine, which for right now, we're using a battery pack, but you would plug it into the wall and roll with it. All right.
Battery is on.
Just as a side note, you don't want to set the battery pack on the machine. It does vibrate off of there. All right. Fish your little piece of rope out, like, up through here. All right. You want to put it through the two hooks. And then you're going to kind of give yourself some room, but you're going to stuff it down in that little hole and try to fish it back out. I think fingers work best. It's still easier than threading a needle.
Yes, it is. Yay.
All right.
Step one.
So, now, I want you to turn the knob on the machine all the way to the turtle. And I want you to flip the machine to the S. All right. Now, hold on to your rope. There you go. All right. Turn. There you go. Towards the rabbit. It's drawing in, right?
Yes.
All right. Turn the machine off when you've about pulled it out of your hand. All right. Now, very gently, try to pull it back towards you. Does it come easy or does it feel like you're going to break something?
It moved the little hook.
All right. Loosen your tension, which means that you're pulling it so it's a little looser.
Okay.
Pull it back out. Does it come out? Easy?
Not easy.
Loosen it again. I mean, it should really, like, just go and come
moves,
out.
If it moves the hooks, that's bad, right?
Right. So, like, put it on, like, nothing tension.
There we go.
That's about right. All right. Now, try it again. Spin it back up again. There you go. Turn it off. Pull it back towards you.
Pretty easy.
Okay. All right. Now, we're going to introduce you to a bat of mohair yarn. All right. Around the center, there's a rubber band. You got to find that rubber band and unwrap it. Okay? Lay it down on the side of the bench, and you're going to kind of unfold it.
Who is this I'm spinning?
I believe this one is Morgana.
Okay.
Because of all the crud that's in there. She's like my dirt digger. Okay. So you're going to want to break off a chunk, like maybe 3 or 4 inches wide. And if you just grab a 3 or 4 inch chunk and hold this one in this hand, it should just yank. There you go.
Oh, that went easy.
Yeah. All right, now I'm going to get this one out of your way. What I want you to do is to practice pulling out the fiber a little at a time. You don't want to pull it the whole way out. You want to pull it so that you're making kind of a little tiny rope of your own, a big fluffy rope. Here, put the one that's loose out to the side because it's going to mess you up.
Like that.
Like that. All right.
But it wants to come all the way out.
Do you see how that happens? Okay, so what you're wanting to do is you want to make sure, because what's going to happen is when you... Stop pulling. When you start pulling this out, slowly, you're going to be able to feel the fibers from the front leaving your hand.
Okay.
So you need to be able to kind of judge those fibers leaving your hand.
Kind of got it started for me.
A little bit. All right. So now.
Okay, there, I felt it.
Yep. All right. Now, you're going to lay that about halfway up your yarn. I mean, go way up.
Okay.
All right. And kind of hold it there. Okay. Now, your wheel is still on pretty slow, right?
Yes.
All right. Take one hand, hold all of your stuff, and take the other hand and turn the wheel on. And just let it spin. Do not let it suck up in the machine yet. Just let it spin. Now, you see the string in front of you is getting tighter and tighter, right?
Yeah.
Now, you've got, there you go, let go of the other hand. Now, pull it back a little bit. Hold the front and pull it back a little bit so that you're stretching that out. There you go. Let it go in. And then stretch it out. There you go.
Is it supposed to do that, or do I need to increase my tension?
You may need to increase the tension a bit. Or the speed. I'm going to increase it just a hair, and we'll turn it back on. Stretch yourself out some, because what you can do to kind of correct that...
Give it more room.
Is give it more room. So where it's not twisty as much, pull it back so that you've got a thin... chunk. You're shooting for something about like that consistently coming out.
I'm spinning rope.
No, you're spinning art yarn. It actually looks pretty good. You'd be surprised. But that's like the hardest thing to understand is how much to let out.
There, now it's sliding.
Now it's sliding?
Okay.
All right. So get it where it's easy for you to slide.
Okay.
All right. Let go of your front hand, because see how it's doubling up on itself? What you can do is grab it here and slide your hand down it and push that spin further down.
Okay.
All right. Now, suck it up into the machine. You have to have it on. All right.
Okay, this thing's going really slow.
It is. You can turn it up a notch. I say start slow because you need to see the twist before you can start playing with it. All right, stop it for a minute. All right.
Now I have to coordinate my two hands.
You do have to coordinate your two hands. All right. I'm going to ask you to pull that out, all the way out, so you can see the yarn again. Can you pull it out easy?
No.
Then. There we go. All right. That's good. All right, now just let it dangle and unwind a little bit. Like,
oh,
drop it to the floor.
I have no idea how much of this is on the camera.
I have no idea either. Not a whole lot.
Okay.
All right. Now, I'm going to say... You are definitely making rope. So I'm going to untwist you a little bit here.
Rope is useful.
Here we go. Here we go. All right. Go ahead and turn the machine on again. All right. Put your finger on the pressure on the brake.
There's no pressure.
Is it on the bobbin? Yeah, it's on the bobbin, but it's not pulling in.
I tightened the brake up. There was no pressure on that brake at all.
All right, let it go in, is what I'm saying. It needs to not spin and go in. I'm going to pause this video.